kingdom as the queen. She was there with the king to participate in all the beauty of the kingdom. But she refused to show herself. She wouldn't come. Why? I don't know. I really don't know. Do you know? But she refused. And when she did, the wrath of the king exploded. And he sought his counselors. And they gave him some very sound advice to put her away. And he was very apt to follow the counsel of his counselors. But that opened the door for another lady in the kingdom to make the right decision. And Esther made the right decision. She became the queen, as you read that story. And she went through the process of sanctification. The right decision led her to the kingdom. The wrong decision led the one away from it. No inheritance at all. The right decision really counts. And the book of Galatians, the 6th chapter, the scripture tells us, be not deceived. Be not deceived. Whatsoever we sow, we shall reap. If we sow to the flesh, we shall of the flesh reap corruption. But if we sow to the Spirit, we shall of the Spirit reap life everlasting. Praise our God. Whatever we sow. And then the verse following that said, be not weary in well-doing. For in due season, we shall reap if we faint not. Thank God for well-doing people on a Sunday night in the tabernacle. I'm here to praise him, rejoice. I have already. Let's give him a praise offering right now and say, Lord, how good it is to be in the house of God. We've had a beautiful day, and I hope you have with your families. And it's been a lovely Christmas day and a wonderful, wonderful time. I hope all of you have enjoyed any moment you spent with your family, with one another, and brothers and sisters in Christ. And I'm so happy to be here tonight and to get this chance to fill the pulpit and take an extra lengthy time to do this. And I thank you for letting me indulge myself preaching this gospel that I love. And I hope tonight that you feel the Lord lifting you up above the shadows and giving you grace in your life. I want you to be happy in the Lord, children of God. I want you to say, I have everything to live for, family of God. I want you to rejoice and know that these are the coming days of greatness in the kingdom of God, in the church of the Lord Jesus Christ. All right? May the Lord bless all the families that have traveled to be with families this weekend. May the Lord bless all the families that are having gatherings tonight of their families. I don't begrudge that. I'm happy to say that I am glad that families can be together on a given day of the year and spend it with their loved ones, if that be the way that it's worked out to be. And I'm happy for you that have spent yours with me in the church today and tonight and last night. Praise the name of the Lord. Thank you for doing it. And we're so glad you have. And may the Lord bless you for being able to be here tonight. And the Lord kept the doors of this place open and the light shining through last night and today and tonight. And we've had three glorious gatherings of the Holy Spirit and the Lord blessing and encouraging and lifting us up and giving us help from God. And I have nothing but good things to say to all of you tonight other than make the right choice, make the right decision, and let God go with you in that. Praise the name of the Lord. I think we prayed for the sick last night, today. We're all aware of who they are. And their names have been called over and over again. So I'm just going to sit down right now and see who has a song, who has a praise, who has a preaching testimony. We'll spend a little while here tonight. We won't be unaware of the fact that some of you still have families to see and some to be concerned about, perhaps before the night is over. And we'll just be satisfied to say we were at the assembly and we praised God, we worshiped him, and we gave him glory. I want you to touch your neighbor next to you right now and say, neighbor, I am glad to be in the house of God with you tonight.
Amen.
Amen, 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 amen. May the Lord bless you real good. Praise our God. Amen, amen. Brother House, play us a number and lift us up with a song. Praise our God. Whatever it is, whatever the Lord gives you, we'll be happy about it.
Amen.
And we'll praise God and rejoice.
Thank you. Praise God. Amen.
Amen. And everybody said, praise the Lord.
Praise God.
Praise the Lord.
Praise God. Praise God. Praise God.
Yeah.
Oh, yes. Glory, 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 glory.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
You know, we should be a lively church, huh?
Amen. Lively
Amen.
Church.
I don't want to fall asleep in here tonight.
Amen.
Not here. I'll wait till I get home.
Praise
the Lord. You know, I was talking to Gloria before I get to church. So most of you know I own a business, and the business in itself is trying to pull me down in every way it can.
Yes.
And sometimes it gets really disheartened and discouraging to deal with it from day to day. But somehow you just pull up the bootstraps and you carry on again. And as many of you own businesses, and I know Brother Don does, and Brother John Stewart does or has, and you know, it takes a really big toll on your life to decide what to do and what not to do. And give me a little more volume, Brother David. Praise God.
Yes, praise God.
Praise God. Amen.
Anyway, it takes a real toll on your body as a whole. So I thought of this song. It's an old song. The boy used to sing with the Oak Ridge Boys. And before that, he was a young talent in the field of gospel music. And he went to his house at Fort Myers and took his own life. But he was a great asset at the time he was singing and doing God's work. He was a great asset to the gospel music. And he wrote this song. And I pray that it blesses you.
Completely to fit his perfect will.
I will, He will supply. We walk together, the Lord and I. I'll stand for Jesus, and let the world go by.
Amen.
Amen.
Glory, glory, glory.
Amen.
Praise our God.
Amen.
Amen.
me a microphone here, please.
I'm okay. Praise God.
Oh, I thought you were going to have to let Sister Phillip a microphone. Amen.
Yeah. Praise God. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you. I'll stand for Jesus.
Brother Michael?
Yes.
It's that time of year.
All right. It is, yeah. Isn't it?
Today is his birthday.
Yes.
Yeah. And we always celebrate his birthday by me standing usually at the back door. And I wrote a little something a few years ago, but it kind of goes along with your ministry. Noah's Ark of today. As I drove into the church driveway, I noticed the first car coming, then another. People walking in from all directions as I looked around. I saw young ones and ones with hair oh so white making their way that night. Some had been coming for many a year, then others for the first time today. They were from all walks of life. You see, a housewife, a teacher, a nurse, a carpenter, a plumber, a student, a fisherman of the sea. From all nations and tongues, we had no special speaker or singing group to entertain. But there was a special guest. Jesus is his name. They were following through the door. They were flowing through the door like the animals into Noah's Ark. They too heard a voice calling, and the sheep know the voice of the shepherd, and none other will they follow. Noah's Ark today is a church on a Saturday night on 7th Avenue. Thank you, Brother Marlowe, for ever keeping the doors open and your light shining. God's love.
Well, thank you.
This is from the church.
Thank the church. I'll thank the rest of them when they get back over the next week, and everybody that may have contributed to this offering, I deeply appreciate it. I'll say that to you that are here tonight, I'll catch the others as I can. But thank you for giving to me on my birthday, and it's just as tremendous as I can make it in my expression to you that I love you and I appreciate you giving and helping me in the ministry all these years. Such a faithful church. My wife and I love you very much, and thank you for giving, every one of you, the witness might or abundantly however God allowed. We're just grateful. Most of all, we're grateful to be here. We're grateful to be included in this great work. You see, I live with not yesterday. We've had a great church here through the years. But I live with a happy anticipation of the tomorrow. In fact, if I'd stand here, I'd get to talking, I'd get inspired again. Because I tell you right now, I don't look back. I don't let things around me. I don't look at what's happening even tonight or today or yesterday. I'm anticipating a wonderful tomorrow. Praise the name of the Lord. Because nothing can ever surpass what God is going to do in the future for his people and the church of the living God. Amen, amen, amen. Well, so I'm just going to pause for station identification, and I'm going to see if the Lord has anything else. And if he does, I'll be right here with it and part of it. And then we're going to start building from this night and into the new year, and we're going to get excited, and there'll be a group of us working day and night to see this place be a revival center for God's love and God's power. Praise God. Thank you for the offering. Thank you. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. Amen.
I always appreciate this particular day because
course, this is the day that we celebrate that our Savior is born. And then also, it's your birthday, and that always means so much to me. I have a song that I know that Brother Cruiser won't be able to play because it's on a CD, and that's okay, but I had worked with several people, but it just, everything kept missing because this person had to go here and there. But it's just something from my heart that, and I think that the church will agree when they play it. But I just want to say thank you for giving to the Lord.
Praise God, yes. Thank you for giving to the Lord.
Amen.
Yes. Praise God. Praise God. Listen to the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Great is your
reward.
Let the family gather closer.
Thank you.
Let the family gather closer. We're family.
I am a life that was changed.
We're family. Year in a few days, it will be past. We're family. Families sometimes disagree. Sometimes families agree. We're family. Sometimes families are hurt and go through pain. And sometimes they just rejoice. And they're so thankful. And they're so happy. But we're family. You're my family. I'm your family. We're the family of God. I don't know what song, but I know there's a song that said, thank you, Lord, for saving my soul. Thank you, Lord, for making me whole. Thank you, for giving to me this great salvation so full of grace. We're family. Praise God.